2 to 4 inches overnight. We're actually talking about some downed trees in addition to the water that's on the roadways. We've got flash flood warnings for Wilkes County. This is where we've already seen some 4 to 5 inches within the last 48 hours. We've had flooding reports coming in. These were from overnight into your early Saturday morning, 1 a.m. through about 10 a.m. this morning. Reports from Latham Park area and Greensboro. Also up in Patrick County, we've got now some flooding concerns in Wilkes County, along with some of those downed trees that are being reported there. We're also looking at the fire department reporting this area here as we looked at Ellendale earlier, just to the north. And so high rainfall totals, 3 to 8 inches. Still in place from what we've seen so far, and an additional of 2 to 4 on top of this, with some higher totals also possible. Some folks might come out with 12 inches by the time this is done, going into your early Tuesday morning. 4.1 inches is the current forecast for the European model, in addition to what we have now. Keep in mind, though, we are getting some really enhanced rainfall totals thanks to the elevation here in the mountains, and we're looking at some devastating flooding potentially in spots, along with that flash flooding that we have tonight. We're looking at that 12-hour forecast. Not a whole lot of change with those temperatures, upper 60s to mid 70s. You might get a little break in the action by middle of the day, but our rain chances remain high. And if you do get some showers rolling through, it may also include a couple of thunderstorms. Temperatures at 74 in Mount Airy. We look at 61 to near 71 in the mountains with that 12-hour forecast, bringing rain chances also back to 90% throughout the day. And those thunderstorms possible there too. 3.38 inches so far in Ennis. We're going to take you over the inch mark now in Mount Airy, and the rain continues to fall in these locations, almost getting up close to 4 inches across parts of the tribe from Hamptonville, which is in southern sections of Wilkes and near Yadkin counties. Look at the visibility issues. Not only do we have to deal with rain, the trees that are coming down in as a result of some of the thunderstorm gusts, but also the soggy soil conditions. Those trees are just coming over very easily. We have to deal with fog tomorrow morning. This will be an issue for us early, and then throughout the afternoon, of course, we'll see some improvements, but then it's going to come right back once those temperatures continue to cool late into the evening hours. You're looking at 3.80 inches in central sections of the Yadkin County area. Some 5 to 6 inch totals, even high 7 inch spots reported in Guilford County and near Thomasville last night. You can see here Kings Creek area, just southern Wilkes County, getting close to that 5 inch mark. And then you go into the eastern sections of the county where you've seen some 2 to 3, and that may also be enough tomorrow. If you add another 1 to 2 to put you back into a flood warning conditions. Furbush, as you go up to Flint Hill, anywhere from 3 to 4 inches there, northern sections of Yadkin County. And you can see where that warning zone is, all the way through Jefferson, Sparta, and along the North Carolina-Virginia border. So these folks here dealing with more rounds of rain, showers, and thunderstorms. And then we've got, of course, concerns too for folks as we go east. Greensboro, Winston-Salem, you're under watches until 8. That continues through tomorrow night. Here's your front down at the surface. We're getting lots of moisture lifting over here, and what's happening aloft is we have this area of low pressure. It's kind of cut off from everything else, and the rest of the flow is just sitting here and spinning, and it also continues to roll. Some of those waves of energy roll through the mid-levels for us. So this is all enhancing our rainfall totals here at the surface. And a reminder about driving, you want to stay off the roads tonight if you can. It's going to be a lot harder to see what's on the ground at night and during the dark. We're talking some heavy rain from Halls Mills, Galax, Sparta, Elkin, and along 601. You're getting a little break here, but again, warnings are up for these locations. Now, Summerfield, Reidsville, and McLeansville, you've already had rounds of rain within the last few hours. You can see how they lifted in from Chapel Hill, kind of skirting up to the north and west. We still have another batch, though, to go, and this is the next round that I'm concerned about through early tomorrow morning. Greenville out through Carlisle, Gaffney, this is going to lift your way, and with this, it's going to be scattered in nature at times. We may get a little break tomorrow. Could we get the dash game in by noontime? We're optimistic, but also realizing that some of these showers and thunderstorms may form overhead tomorrow, and with that help aloft, that we can see the timing adjusted a little bit, but I'm hopeful that we might get in a few activities tomorrow before more thunderstorms could pose flooding and flash flooding risks for us into Monday. Monday also looking showery still, but Tuesday's looking better with more sunshine. Your estimated rainfall out there, as we mentioned, anywhere from 3 to 5 inches, some high 8 inch totals also. And your 7 day forecast showing you 76 degrees, folks, for highs tomorrow. We should be able to get you back into the 80s. Some pockets of sunshine may appear in spots, but not everywhere. And then the sun trying to work its way back out with low to mid 80s for Friday and Saturday.